Hello students, so far we have discussed about MOSFET and MOS system. In that we have discussed different aspects of MOSFET. Now we are going to discuss the MOSFET operation and analysis in detail. It includes several aspects like your current equations, your operations and other aspects. So, as far as modes of operation are concerned, we are going forward for derivations. So, before we derive anything, there are certain assumptions that are to be made. The first assumption that is to be made is that the MOSFET we are going to use for derivation is N-channel enhancement type. Also, the body of the MOSFET is connected to ground. We know that your MOSFET is a 4-terminal device. So here in this case, what we have done, we have connected body to the ground. So overall, source and body both are connected to ground. So BSV is equal to 0. So these are certain assumptions as far as your modes of operations are being concerned. Now the first mode that is of important, not of importance, and as far as equations are concerned, is being given by that when your gate potential is in between threshold voltage of the MOS and zero, then your channel is not being created. Here you can see there is no creation of channels here. When there is no creation of channels, what happens? There will be no movement of electrons from source to drain. So there is no channel, there is no conduction. So this is called cutoff mode. Now next mode that is very important in MOSFET is called linear mode of operation. So linear mode can be divided into several factors and it is also known as active mode or triode mode. So here you can see that when your gate source voltage, that is the voltage you are applying on the gate, is greater than threshold voltage of the MOSFET, then this is the driving equation of your MOSFET. That means if you want your MOSFET to be in linear region, or if you want to operate your MOSFET in linear region, these are the voltage equations need to be followed. So your gate source voltage is greater than threshold voltage. Also, your drain to source voltage is somewhere less than saturation voltage. Now, I will be discussing saturation voltage. Now, what is saturation voltage? Suppose you are having some device. You are increasing the input and your output is linearly increasing. But that is not the case. Sometimes it happens, irrespective of increase in the output, input, there is no increase in the output. So, in those conditions, we say that your device is saturated. That means, if you are applying an input of certain volts, the maximum voltage that your device can provide at the output is equivalent to your power supply. That is, in most of the cases, we use term VDD. So your maximum voltage is VDD. So if your output is in this particular range and your gate source voltage is greater than threshold voltage, or we can say your VGS is greater than VT is equal to 0, then we can say your device is actually in linear mode. So due to these conditions, what happens when your device is in linear region? Inversion of channel occurs and a conducting channel is being formed. So, for a VDS greater than 0, a current proportional to VDS flows from the source to drain. The MOSFET channel behaves like a voltage control resistance. So, here you can see, we are having a MOSFET and here we have applied certain potential on the gate. So, because of that, what happens? A channel is being created. Now, this channel is not like this, and channel is like this. So the reason is we are applying certain potential at the drain. So this will cancel out some of the potential here, and as we move away from the drain towards the source, the effect of voltage on drain is reduced, and here you can have full channel. So once you apply certain potential on the gate, your channel is created, and if you apply certain potential at the drain and source, electric field is being created, and because of this electric field, what happens? Electrons from the source will start moving towards drain. Thus, current is being there, and current is there depends this on so drain and source. So your movement of electrons is in this direction, and your movement of current is in this direction, conventionally opposite to the movement of electrons. So we have studied right now the linear mode of operation. Now next is pinch off. Now what happens if your gate to source voltage is greater than threshold voltage, and the voltage we are applying on the drain, and why we are using VTS here, because the difference between VD and VS. Now what is VD? VD is voltage applied at the drain, and VS is voltage applied at the source. So as we have assumed that your VS is grounded, so VS is nothing but zero. So what happens? Your VDS is actually voltage, effective voltage. So this is the maximum saturation voltage that your device can give. So if you are having these conditions, that means your device has reached a point that is called pinch off point, and it is almost edge of the saturation. Now what do you know as saturation? That means irrespective of increasing the drain to source voltage, your output will not be going to increase anymore. It is saturated, and this is due to velocity saturation. So these are certain points. What are those points? Channel just reaches the drain. Yes, channel is almost near the drain. Channel is reduced to zero inversion charge at the drain, and drifting of electrons through the depletion region between the channel and drain has begun. And we are using this particular term VGS. So effective voltage that is in the channel is VGS minus VT naught, where VGS is voltage at gate with respect to source, and VT naught is threshold voltage of the MOS. So if you are applying 5 volts here and your threshold voltage is 1, then effective voltage that is being created in the channel is 4 volt, and if you are applying 4 volt here, what happens? This is 0. So now when you move away from the drain, what happens? This becomes 0.1 and so on. In between it becomes 2 volts, then 3 volts at this particular point, and so on. So these points are very important, and you can find out here exactly in the previous case when your device is in linear region, your channel is like this, but here your channel is like this. That means your channel has reached a condition called pinch off point, and after that, if you further increase this drain to source voltage, that means you increase voltage at this particular point, what happens? Pinch of the channel starts, and the channel length is reduced, and it is going further towards the source. So we avoid device to be operating in this particular region, because after that there is no advantage. As earlier, what happens? There are two electric fields. One electric field is in this direction, other electric field is in this direction under the influence of drain current. So if you increase the voltage, what happens? There is no effect of electric field, because the velocity of your electrons, that is 10 to the 7 meter per second, has already achieved by electron, and further increase in the electric field due to applied potential at drain does not have any impact on the movement of electrons. So that's a very, very important thing. So we have studied three different modes of operation: cutoff mode, linear mode, and this is called pinch off or saturation pinch off mode. So now, if you further increase your potential here greater than the saturation voltage, then what happens? Channel is shortened. So I have already described this in the previous slide, that your channel starts diminishing or channel starts vanishing in this particular direction. Now, drift due to high electric field produces potential between the drain and the source end of the channel, and velocity saturation leads to saturation current. That means your current is fixed. No matter how much potential you're applying at the drain, leading to electric field and electrons are moving from here to here, but there is no further possibility of movement of electrons at a higher velocity. So that means if velocity is constant, number of carriers that are passing through this channel is same. So these equations are very important, and this equation is called overdrive voltage, as already mentioned, that if voltage at this particular point VD is greater than the voltage at VGS minus VT naught, where VGS is voltage of gate with respect to source, VDS is voltage at drain with respect to source, minus threshold voltage. Threshold voltage is threshold voltage of the MOS. If this voltage is greater than this, what happens? Your device moves into saturation region. Now, so far we have studied about your MOSFET. Now, as far as your devices are being concerned, without their characteristics, it is very difficult to get into the detailed analysis. As IV characteristics help us how your device responds to various sets of inputs. In this discussion, I will be focusing on how you can analyze your device for a better understanding of your MOSFET working. So now, we are trying to use gradual channel approximation for the description of IV characteristics of the MOSFET. Now, you can see that this is your source end, this is your drain end. The channel width is W, and entire exercise is being there so that we can find out the current along the channel at any point. So conditions I will discuss as we move on in this particular presentation. So here you can see your Y is equal to 0 and Y is equal to L, and also we are focusing on a very small area. So this is nothing but an inversion layer, and that relates to the conduction of your MOSFET. So now, when we look forward for any sort of derivation, the main focus is equations, how your equations are actually moving. So you can see that for a linear mode, your VGS should be greater than threshold voltage, and your VDS should lie somewhere in between 0 and maximum saturation voltage. So next is, your threshold voltage should be somewhere in between in this point, and here your VDS should be less than VGS minus VT naught. So now, the channel is created near the drain, and VCY is channel voltage with respect to the source at position Y, and boundary conditions are also there. So boundary condition says that your channel length at Y is equal to 0, this, this, so these are certain values, And this is how your diagram actually looks like when your device is actually giving you this particular point that you are applying some potential at the gate that is greater than threshold voltage, and also you are applying certain potential at the drain terminal. So with respect to source, this is called VDS. So here you can see that the channel is being created, channel is being tapered. The reason for that is, suppose you are applying some positive potential here. So this is oxide, so this is nothing but a capacitance. So equal capacitance will be there on this particular side. So as we already know that effective voltage is your gate source voltage minus VT naught. So if you are applying suppose 5 volts and your threshold voltage is 1, so that means we are getting 4 volts at this particular point. So now we have applied certain potential on the drain source. Suppose you are applying 1 volt here, what happens? This voltage is going to be 3. So this is having a gradient from 4 to 3. So if you increase it to 2, what happens? This becomes 2 volts and this slightly moves. If you are making it 3, it becomes 1 volt. If you are making it 4 volts, then it is further tapered and your device is now into saturation. So your device saturation is being decided by the amount of potential you are applying on the drain source potential. So your current is in this direction and one electric field is in next direction, other direction is y direction, and there are certain assumptions for this derivations. What are those assumptions? That your substrate bias voltage is 0. That means your substrate source as well as body is grounded and they are not being applied any potential. Also, your threshold voltage is constant along the entire channel. Although it depends upon manufacturing process, what we assume that if this is the case, it is the best case that your threshold voltage should be constant along the channel. Otherwise, you will have a different voltages at the different point of the channel. Another point that is of importance, that we are having two electric fields, one in the y direction, another in the x direction, and we assumes that your electric field in the y direction dominates as compared to x direction. So also current flow in the y axis can be considered. Now when we move towards direction derivations, we know that your cutoff mode, there is no current and there is no current flow in the device. So next mode is linear mode. So let's discuss. So now we look forward for how to calculate current in this particular equation for the MOSFET. So how we will find out the current? We are actually looking forward to calculate the drain current inside the channel. So if we look at the drain current is nothing but charge per unit time. That means we are looking forward for charge in this particular area. So it's a simple process done otherwise. So first thing is, we are looking forward for charge. This is charge. So the mobile electron charge density in the surface inversion layer. So how inversion happens? When we apply some potential on the gate, so that leads to inversion below that gate. So now your charge is directly related to capacitance into voltage. Q is equal to C into V. So what we actually do, we will put these terms in the equation. Now capacitance, because we are focusing on oxide capacitance, we are focusing on gate. So oxide capacitance is there, Cox. So we are actually focusing on that. Next is, what are the various voltages that are associated in that particular region? So various voltages that are associated in this region is gate source voltage, VGS, and as we know that effective voltage is whatever you are applying on the gate minus threshold, minus threshold. So this gives you the effective potential in that, and also voltage in the channel at particular point Y. So that need to be subtracted. So that gives you the exact idea of how much charge is there. From charge, we will try to calculate the differential resistance. As already known, that when we are actually applying potential on the gate, it actually changes the conductivity of the channel. So it is nothing, it is actually sort of variable resistance. So, and also it is related to electronic surface mobility, mu n. So wherever we are using mobility, we are using mu n, because we are talking about electrons. So now your differential resistance dr is somehow related to dy, that is the small length in which we are focusing, over conductivity of that particular area into cross-sectional area. This is all we are talking about. Now your conductivity is q mu n na, okay, and your area is width into x d, that means that area, so this is cross-section. So x-axis we are talking about, so area is in cross-section, and where it is very small, so it's not a three-dimensional, it's a two-dimensional thing, so it's a cross-sectional. So now we will get it solved, and this is nothing but q into cv. So this is your charge in that particular area. So this is your differential resistance is somehow related to your charge. Also your voltage in the channel is current into resistance, current into resistance. So your current is id and resistance we have already found out, so we substitute that in this particular value. Now this is in very small area, so what we are actually doing is actually integrating on the particular equation for the given boundary conditions. So when you have observations on this regard, you will find out that we are actually integrating this for the limits 0 to L, and where L is the length of the channel, and we are integrating on y axis. Then these terms are constant because they depends upon the fabrication thing. The only thing is being changed is current, and that depends upon what potential you are actually applying, and it also depends upon 0 to VDS. Inversion also depends upon VDS. So this is the small change in the channel thing. So overall you are getting this expression from the previous equations. So when you write it, you will get the final equation, and I want you people to remember this equation by heart. This is a drain current equation for a linear current, or your device is operating in a linear mode, and from this you will find out this is mobility, this is oxide capacitance, this is width of the channel, this is length of the channel. So these two are fixed depending upon the manufacturing process, and also your length is fixed. Once technology is fixed that you are supposed using 90 nanometers, so this is fixed. The only thing which can be changed is width and other parameters which can be changed. So VT naught is somehow dependent upon VSV, as already discussed with you in the previous videos. So that's all as far as your linear current equation for your MOSFET operating in a linear mode is being concerned. Now next is when your device is actually operating in saturation mode. This is the next thing we are looking forward. What happens when your VGS is greater than VT naught and your VDS is equal to VD saturation? That means your device enters into saturation mode. So channel reaches the drain but is reduced to zero inversion charge at the drain. That means no charge is at the drain, and electrons drift the depletion between the channel and the drain. So this is the maximum velocity your electron can achieve. So in saturation mode, these are the equations. So after that, what happens? Your pinching of channel starts, and you substitute this equation in the linear one, and you end up with this particular equation. So this is your drain current when your device is in saturation mode. So these two equations are very, very important when you are going for analysis of any circuit using your PMOS or NMOS. As already discussed with you people, that we are going to make some circuits from that. So device can either operate in cutoff region or in saturation region or in linear region. So depending upon the region of operation, this can be used for analysis purpose. Now, this is what sort of characteristics your device have. So this is your NMOS, and we are applying gate source potential here. This is gate, this is drain, this is source, and this is body. Body is grounded, and this is drain to source potential. Now what you actually do, you actually change the gate voltage. So when you actually changing the gate voltage, so initially your device does not conduct because it has to overcome some threshold voltage. So once threshold voltage is overcome, your drain current starts increasing and your device is saturated at some particular point. So this is one of the characteristics of your device. Another characteristics are like this. So here, when you increase the drain voltage at a particular gate source voltage, initially your drain current increases and after that it saturates. Similarly here, initially it increases and after that it saturates. Initially it increases and after that it saturates. So here this is the saturation region beyond this. That means you increase drain voltage, it does not have any effect on the drain current. So this is due to your velocity saturation. So these are the IV characteristics of your MOSFET. Now one thing that is important as far as your MOSFET operation is being concerned, that when your pinch off is arrived, after that you have observed that your channel is actually shrinking. So because of that, what happens, we have observed that your drain current is somehow related to inversion relation to length. Now length of the channel is reducing, so instead of getting like this, your current equation is like this. So this particular phenomena is called channel length modulation. So initially it is fine, but later on we cannot neglect it, this small thing. So to include this particular thing, a factor called channel length modulation factor is being included. So once your device is in saturation, then what you can do, this factor need to be added to this particular equation. So how we have observed, we know that actual channel length is channel length, actual channel length, channel length, this is channel length at present after pinch off, and this is reduction in channel length. So this is L dash. So this is being substituted here. So this is having inverse relation with this. So if this keep on decreasing, this keeps on increasing. So going for analysis, so this factor is being replaced with this 1 plus lambda VDS. So we substitute it. So this is how channel length modulation is being included into your device. So normally whenever we use some models, this value is being provided by the manufacturers, otherwise we can calculate it using simple manipulation. So summary, what we have done in this particular module, we have studied about IC technology, we have studied about MOS physics, and we have studied about MOSFET working principle. We have also studied about IV characteristics MOSFET and current equation of a linear and saturation mode, and also we have studied channel length modulation. So this is overall summary that we need in the near future when we study about your circuits. So I hope you understand all the topics what we have discussed, although I have missed some of them due to scarcity of time. But if you have any doubt, you can email me. I will try to address each and every concern. Book I have followed is CMOS Digital Integrated Circuits by S. Kang, and I am using the material provided by them as a instructor material. So next time when we meet, we start going for some other areas which are related for digital circuit design. So thank you very much.